It feels great to be back in a performance space performing, and I'm especially thrilled to be performing a collaborative work, as that's what we've all been missing so much this year, togetherness. A couple of observations I've had about this piece and this movement. I should probably introduce myself, that would help all of you. So my name is Benjamin Doan, and I'm 20 years old, from Rochester, New York. And this, my wonderful pianist, Ian Lee, and I will perform Beethoven's second cello sonata in G minor, and we'll be playing the introduction and allegro, which comprise the first movement. When playing this piece, I often think of Gothic literature, which was a genre that was very popular during Beethoven's lifetime. For example, the opening processional passage the piano plays reminds me of a barren landscape with a ruined castle at its center. Later on, the more tumultuous sections seem to me to explore this narrator's inner regrets and torments. Of course, this is not a programmatic piece, and you are free to come up with whatever narrative you wish as a playlist. And in any case, it's a pleasure to be able to play for you today, and thank you very much.
Virtuosity and flashiness. There are so many emotional complexities in this work, but it is one of those masterpieces that is able to explain what is so high up that cannot be explained in words. I'm so grateful to be able to perform this in front of a live audience, and I hope that this work will take you to a magical place. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you. Hi, everyone. My name is Henry Rogers, and I'm a violinist from Princeton, New Jersey. Tonight, Phelan and I will be performing the second and third movements of Ravel's Violin Sonata No. 2. This piece, Ravel was very interested in American blues, and the second movement really reflects that sort of its combination of American harmonies and Ravel's own French Impressionist style. The third movement is a perpetual motion, with the piano providing some very distinct rhythms under the violin's constant line. So thank you all for coming, and I hope you enjoy.
It's so nice to see so many people here for this concert. This is actually one of our biggest audiences of the year on our Mary Baldwin night, and we're always thrilled to see so many of you here filling the pews. Which means that it goes segues directly into, this is usually what I call the commercial segment, but there's another part of the newspapers I'm going to share with you tonight, which is the corrections segment. And the corrections is that somebody stood here 48 hours ago and declared that the Piano Palooza would be held in Francis Auditorium. Management regrets the error. Actually, it's proven to be too popular for us to fit into Mary Baldwin's Francis Auditorium. So it will indeed, the Piano Palooza will be on Monday night, and it will be right here on stage. Now, it may also be a four-hour program, but more on that later. Before then, though, we do have some wonderful concerts coming up here to close out week three. Tomorrow, you'll be hearing from the Emporia Duo, the Occoquan Trio, and the Rapidan and Albemarle and Roanoke Quartets. They are not bluegrass bands. We try to give our students a little something who come from all over the world, a little something to remember Virginia by. So we come up with some Virginia-based titles for them. These are the names of our quartet and other chamber music ensembles that have been playing in what we now call Group A. These are the students who have been here for 4 weeks and are about to share with us all of their chamber music that they've been working on so intensively. We had a fantastic rehearsal this afternoon, and I am so looking forward to what they're going to share with you. This is at the Stanton Augusta Arts Center tomorrow at 1 o'clock. That is a free concert, but do bear in mind that you do need to reserve in advance because of limited seating, but it's going to be just a terrific concert. Our celebrity series, week three, is at 6 o'clock in this space tomorrow, and we'll get to hear from the violin and piano and real life duo of Christopher Tong and Mickey Sawada. We're going to hear from our communication training teacher, who is making her celebrity series debut as an artist, the wonderful, wonderful Melissa White, who was a yoga teacher here and is also a member of the Harlem Quartet. She'll be playing the sparkling Mozart Violin Concerto No. 3. The Borromeo Quartet will be bouncing in with Jesse Montgomery's strut, and we're going to end the program with an amazing trio of Shannon Lee, Amit Paled, and Paul Neubauer playing the Dauphnani Serenade. It should be really a wonderful concert. Our Heifetz Hoot Nanny resumes again at the Blackburn Great Hall on Saturday night, and on Sunday, back in this space, we're going to have a chance to hear another fantastic, moving second movement of a great concerto. That will be Julia Angeloff playing the second movement of the Sibelius Violin Concerto. Shannon Lee, also one of our wonderful teachers here, and by the way, came to the Institute when she was 12 years old. So it's been such a pleasure to see her mature as an artist and as a teacher here at the Institute. And the third of our four Ashkenazi Kirschbaum seminar groups will be taking center stage in the second half, doing the complete Brahms string quintet in Opus 111. So lots to look forward to, and in fact, I'm not quite done yet, because we'll be back at the Vineyard, at Barron Ridge Vineyards, on Sunday evening at 7 p.m. What a gorgeous setting. Our students were so inspired to play there, and when they finish playing, it's just about sunset, so they get to watch the sunset and enjoy it, and those over 21 maybe even get a glass of wine. Anyway, lots to look forward to. Hope to see you there. And I'll say one more time in the corrections department that the Piano Palooza will be here on Monday night. Thanks again, and enjoy the second half of our program.
a month ago, and we've had such a wonderful and positive experience here at the Heikes Institute so far. And we're so fortunate to work with such amazing artists and dance as coaches. Today, we will be performing Schubert's String Quartet in A minor. And during the conception of this piece, Schubert was extremely ill, and he was profoundly depressed. And in a letter to a close friend of his, he confided that, quote, "I feel myself the most unfortunate, the most miserable being in the world. Think of a man whose health will never be right again, and who from despair over the fact makes it worse instead of better." So he's 27, he's extremely ill, he's penniless, and he is so overcome with a sense of failure, but somehow he still manages to compose three monumental chamber works, all in the span of 1 year, when he is 27. And so the first theme, Death of the Maiden, and then there's an Op. 10 F major, and finally is our piece, the Quartet in A minor. And this piece is nicknamed the Rosalinda, and it gets this nickname from the second movement. Schubert had a habit of borrowing from himself melodies, and in this case, he recycled a motif that he had used, had written for a score for a short-lived play that was called Rosamunda Fürstin von Zypern, which in English means Rosamunda, the Princess of Cyprus. So despite being so sick and so ill and in so much pain, both mentally and physically, I find it so amazing that he was able to persevere and continue writing and composing. And not only just composing, but composing such wonderful, beautiful, and timeless works. And it has been such an honor for us to study and to learn this piece of music together as a quartet, and it is such an honor to play it for you this evening. So without further ado, we hope you enjoy. Thank you.
Thank you.